लेट अस क्लोज योर आईज, ब्रिंगिंग अवर अटेंशन टू द ब्रेथ. लेट अस रिमेंबर द प्रेजेंस ऑफ गॉड एंड मास्टर्स ऑल अराउंड अस, विद इन अस, इन द ब्रेथ. Let us mentally offer our prayers, respect, mentally bow to all the visible and invisible saints and sages . May the blessings of Lord, blessings of masters guide us. Please listen to this prayer. ॐ सदाशिवसमारम्भं श्यामाचरणमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तं वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करम् ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मैति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवत् व्याप्तदेहाय श्रीदक्षिणामूर्तये नमः. ओपन योर आईज, वेलकम बैक. थैंक यू फॉर जॉइनिंग. माय हार्टफेल्ट ग्रैटिट्यूड दैट यू आर एबल टू जॉइन. प्लीज ओपन द भगवद गीता बुक एंड आई एम चैंटिंग द फर्स्ट वर्स ऑफ द गीता ध्यानम. इफ यू कैन चैंट विथ मी और यू कैन जस्ट लिसन टू इट. ॐ पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीं अम्ब त्वामनुसन्दधामि भगवत् गीते भवद्वेषिणीम्. आई एम बाउिंग टू डिवाइन मदर द भगवद गीता एंड बाउिंग टू लॉर्ड. आई एम बाउिंग टू मास्टर्स एंड आई बाउिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. सो वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग इन लास्ट थ्री क्लासेस. अनफॉर्चुनेटली वी कुड नॉट ऑर्गेनाइज द क्लास लास्ट वेंसडे बिकॉज ऑफ द इंटरनेट problem here. There was a storm a few days ago. Unfortunately, the internet is back. So today, we have discussed chapter 1 and chapter 2, just to summarize in few words. In the first chapter, Arjuna has got into a confusion, a state of a delusion, thinking that there are friends and families with whom I have to fight, and it doesn't look like something I should do. And another thing is that if the fight happens, there would be consequences which would be devastating. And Arjuna hence thinks that this is not a righteous war, and hence he has asked Lord to help him to clarify whether his thinking is right or not. Initially, Lord asks him to stand up and think clearly. Then when Arjuna says that, Lord, I cannot fight with this kind of mindset, I feel so weak, I feel so confused that it is not possible for me to fight, and he sits down, Lord smiles and says that, you know, please understand properly and then you can decide what you have to do. So Lord has started teaching because Arjuna asked for guidance. In chapter 2, this happened, part of it happened in chapter 2 as well. In chapter 2, there is a discussion between, Lord is elaborating. In the first phase, Lord says, the highest knowledge, which says that we are eternal, we have no death, no birth, we cannot be soaked in water, we cannot be moved by air, we cannot be we cannot be made dirty by dust. Like that, Lord says that you are pure, you are indivisible, and we have been, Lord mentioning himself and Arjuna, that we have been there eternally, we are here today, and we will be there eternally as well. Hence, your confusion or your delusion doesn't make any sense. After that, Lord gives a very brief introduction that, however, even if you know this, you should do your duty, because this body is temporary. It was there day before yesterday. It is there today. It won't be there tomorrow. So don't worry. Just do your duty. In second chapter, Arjuna asks that, "Oh Lord, how do I know who has, you gave me this knowledge, how do I know who has perfected this knowledge? If a knowledge that has not be, that cannot be practiced, it is not useful for us." So he says, "Sthitapragyanse kaabhasa," how do I know somebody has manifested whatever knowledge you have given me? How do I know that? So Lord has given number of signs, clarifications, characteristics, qualities through which a person can be tested whether the person has achieved the knowledge or not. This is where Lord has ended. But because in the first chapter, Lord has given prominence to knowledge, and knowledge means highest knowledge, that, oh Arjuna, you are indivisible, you are self, you are eternal, you are Atman. When Lord has said this, and at the same time, Lord has gently pushed him that you stand up and do your activities. So if we put ourselves in the Arjuna's shoes and this kind of teachings come to us from Master, saying one thing, asking us to do something that we feel opposite, a question arises in our mind that you are saying something and you are asking me to do something. Why is that? So similarly, Arjuna has asked clearly that, "Oh Lord, you have been telling me that there is knowledge and this knowledge is highest knowledge. And if that is so, then why are you pushing me to do action?" Action here means to go and fight. It doesn't make sense to me. You are one time, you are telling that you are eternal, this, that. So whether I fight or I do not fight, how does it matter? That is the question in Arjuna's mind. Then he asks, like a student should always ask whenever there is a confusion, he asks, "Please tell me clearly, without confusing me with mixed words, what is beneficial for me?" I would like to draw your attention here. We have talked about an example. Suppose you have gone to a market, and suppose we have gone to a shoe store, for example, and in that shoe store, everything is 80% discount. And I looked and I found a beautiful, a nice shoe, pair of shoes, and it is, why 80%? Since we are imagining, let's make 90% discount. So 90% discount. I picked it up and it is size 9 and my size is 6. Will I buy this just because it is 90% discount? I will not buy this even if it is 90% or 95%, even if it is 99% discount. If it is free, maybe. If it is 99% discount, I will not buy this because it is not useful for me. Similarly, it does not matter what is best, what is greatest, what is highest. If there is no utility in that knowledge for me. Hence, Arjuna's question is very prominent, very interesting and very clear, is that, "Oh Lord, please do not confuse me with so many words, what is right, what is wrong, this, that. Please tell me clearly what would be beneficial, what would be best for me." In our life, when we go to a teacher, it is not necessary we should ask, what is the best knowledge? What do you know? The teacher may know many things. That doesn't matter to me. What matters to me is that I am in confusion. I have doubts. I need to get out of that doubt. Hence, tell me what would best be suitable for me to get out of the doubt. So Arjuna's question is very clear, sharp, crisp in that sense that he says, there is knowledge, you have told about knowledge, you are also telling about action. Please tell me clearly what is suitable for me. So Lord is assuring through gentle words, Lord says that there are two types of action. There are two types of path I have given in the past. One is the path of knowledge, another is the path of action or path of yoga. And then the Lord says, look, even if you think that just because you know the knowledge, you can sit down and be in the knowledge or you can practice knowledge, that is not so. There is a path, there is a systematic way, and let me explain that further. With that, Lord says, I have given two types of path. One is knowledge, one is action. However, please know that without action, there is no possibility to go or to attain the state of perfection. So action here, that yoga of action or the path of yoga, he says without yoga, there is no possibility to attain perfection. Additional to that, Lord says, also know that there is no possibility for anyone, for that matter, who can stay without activities for a moment. First, you cannot stay a moment without activities, and you cannot be perfect. You cannot attain knowledge without activities. So if we put it together, it means that be attentive and know clearly what I'm going to say. Lord says that in this path of action, you find what your duties are. Lord calls it as swadharma. He says you find whatever you consider as your duty and do it systematically, and I will tell you what are the process. Lord says, even if while you are doing your own duty, you die, that is a much more better proposition than doing somebody's work and succeed. So there is an example that has been given that suppose you go to somebody who really loves painting. There are people who are passionate to paint. Suppose they're doing paintings and they're painters. And you say, look, I'm going to give you several millions of dollars and I would like you not to paint whole of your life. Will that person agree? Well, you say some may agree, but then they're not passionate. They may agree because they have been doing it for money. If you really go to a person who is dedicated to his or her duty and you offer something, whatever it is, wealth, whatever it is, and ask that person to leave that duty and do something else, you can very well see that the person is not going to do that. And even if he or she does, very well he is going to suffer. He's going to be unhappy, depressed, and it is not impractical, or it is not very unusual to see this in our life or with people around us. So Lord says that you do your duty or do your activities, and then Lord adds a very critical component to it. He says, with proper attitude. He said, do your activities, but with proper attitude. We will talk about what are the attitudes Lord has given, a list of attitudes. But let us first understand or remember that Lord is telling activities plus attitude. Together, it becomes meditation. Together, it becomes yoga. To give you an example of attitude, Suppose you have a piece of furniture. It has happened to me actually. I went to one place and there is this piece of furniture. It looks very old. Very old, and you can't sit even. Like if you do like this, it will fall. And I was wondering why they have it here. It was in one monastery. And then I came to know it has been used by the great Swami Vivekananda. So because the furniture has been used maybe once or twice or maybe multiple times by a great personality whom we adore, we respect, the value of that furniture has gone up. It is something we know. I live in Chicago, and in Indiana, there are lot of antique stores. And you go there, you find something. Sometimes I feel, who buys this? But people buy, because it has been associated with something. People buy antique cars. Why? Similarly, if there is a letter, somebody whom we love, a mother, our mother or grandmother, or somebody whom we love or like, has sent to us, that piece of paper is much more valuable to us than any a book or anything like that. Why? It is because of the attitude that we, through which we look at that piece of paper. So similarly, Lord says that do activities with a proper attitude. And then Lord says that remember how you do action. You always do action. You means us here. We always do action either through likes or through dislike. If we like somebody, we go towards that person. If we do not like somebody, we go away from that person. So liking and disliking drives us. And hence, we are not able to maintain proper attitude. When Lord says this, Arjuna asks, "Oh Lord," this is at the end of the chapter, Arjuna is asking. He said, "Oh Lord, if it is so clear that some of the action we do can bring us misery and some of the action can bring us freedom, then why me and others also get prompted to these actions that bind us? Why is that?" So Lord says, and like basically Lord Arjuna is asking, what is forcing us to do something knowingly that this action is not good? What is that? Why does this happen? Lord is answering, saying that, look, it is happening because there are two things, let me tell you. One is kama, desire. One is krodha, anger. So within you, these two characteristics come. And because of that, you are forced to do some action. And eventually, you do the action with liking and disliking. And then you get entangled into it. What brings us those two, desire and anger? We'll little bit analyze what is desire and what is anger soon. Lord says it is because of the rajasic activities of your mind. So in our mind, there are three kinds of characteristics or qualities: sattvic, rajasic, and tamasic. So this rajasic aspect of the mind is the reason because of which desires and anger comes to us. And because of these two, we are prompted or forced to do some action, even if we know that this action is not suitable or proper for me. What is desire? Desire is something that our sense organs wants to enjoy. Tongue wants to enjoy some sweet thing. Eyes wants to see something good, something enjoyable. Nose wants to smell something sweet, something good, fragrance. Ears wants to listen something good, some music. Because of that, we are attracted towards the object. So our sense organs creates an intention within us to have something, and that we call as desire. And who is prompting the sense organs? Mind is prompting the sense organs. So we are prompted to go towards the object, and when, for some reason or the other, whether through nature, whether through people, whether through our own inability, whether through our own lack of capacity, if this desire is not getting fulfilled, we get angry. So suppose I would like to enjoy 5 sweets and somehow I am not able to get that sweets and my desire is strong, I'll get anger. So Lord says, these two, your intentions to enjoy an object, and when that doesn't happen, the anger that you get, the frustrations that you get within, is the reason why you are not able to stay in knowledge, and knowledge is covered by these two. Lord gives a beautiful example. Like fire is covered by smoke, similarly, knowledge is covered by this desire and anger. Where is this? I briefly discussed, where is this desire and anger residing? They are residing in our sense organs. We have 10 sense organs. They are residing in that. They are also residing in mind. They are also residing in intellect. Hence, controlling the sense organs, controlling the mind, controlling the intellect, only by controlling these, by properly working on these three, we will be able to remove this cover so that knowledge can manifest. So see how clearly Lord is taking us step by step, very clearly telling, control the sense organs, control the mind, control the intellect, and then when this is controlled, or when these are controlled, then the cover would be removed, and when the cover is removed, self will manifest, and when self manifests, then you know who you are, and that is knowledge. Lord says again that by knowing self, when you know the self, then that is where your realization comes, and that can only happen through activities or karma yoga or the yoga of action. The yoga of action has 2 components, we can say, bodily and mentally. When we do bodily action, it purifies the body. When we do mental action, it purifies the mind. The beauty is that karma yoga is not done separately, something for the body, something for the mind. It is done together, and hence it purifies both body and the mind. An example that has been given by masters, by a great spiritual teacher from Catholic tradition, his name is Brother Lawrence. There is a book. What is that book's name? Something, Master or something. Anyway, Brother Lawrence, I forgot that book's name. In that book, so he says what Brother Lawrence did, he was not very educated. So he went to the monastery and asks, what can he do? They said, clean the utensils. So he will clean the utensils, and while cleaning, he started thinking that I am cleaning the mind. And it is said that because of that, his mind got purified. In many spiritual, there is a spiritual master, his name is Debra Baba. He used to clean his pot so clearly, thinking that it is nothing but the reflection of the mind. Nevertheless, how do we do this yoga of action through which our mind and body would be purified? Lord is telling, first, do not get attached to the action, and also do not get attached to the results of the action. Whenever we do an action, there would be results. Any action will bring certain amount of results, some kind. We know that according to the Master's teaching, according to the Bhagavad Gita also, that the result is not in our control. We do not know when the result will come, how the result would come. Hence, getting attached to the result will bind us to the activities. The second thing that we should never discourage others to do action. It is not proper. Lord has given example of himself saying that, look, even if I don't do anything, nobody is going to hold me responsible. But nevertheless, I continue to do my activities. Practically, we can see in our life, if we look at Sri Guruji, he is constantly in action. And he has many times told us, in private, in public, I have never wasted a moment of my life, a moment of my time. Time waste is mind waste, he says. So looking at the master, looking at the teachings of Lord, it is not at all proper to discourage others to do action, saying that, no need to do action, because if you sit just quiet, then everything will happen. Then the third thing Lord has told, that know that whatever action you are doing, the action is done at the level of matter. Mind is matter, intellect is matter, sense organs are matter, body is matter, objects are matter, the world we are operating is matter. So know that everything is done by matter, through matter, within matter. Knowing this, don't get attached to it. Then Lord says that do not create I-ness of the work, because Prakriti or nature is doing its own act. So do not create I-ness and offer your activities to Lord, to masters, to social service, society. Offer it away. Offer it. The difference, it is very difficult to see the activities between a person of knowledge and a person of ignorance. Because a person of knowledge does the same thing what a person of ignorance does. A master, a guru, is doing same types of activities what we are doing as well. The only difference is that the attitude they have for the action is very different than the attitude that we have for ourselves. Then Lord says, control the sense organs. Don't do activities for sense enjoyments. Make sure that your activities is matching scriptural injunctions or the teachings of masters. Make sure that our activities are through proper guidance. Just don't take up anything else. And through this methodology, there will be growth within you. There will be mental growth. There will be purification in the body, in the mind. And hence, once the mind is purified, once the body is purified, then this desire and anger, the layer of desire and anger will be removed, and the self, effulgent self, would manifest. Lord says, make sure I gave you these ideas. And Lord has given a little more, because of time we are not going through it. But these are more core aspects of how to do activities. Lord says, be very clear. If you do opposite of it, who is going to suffer? You are going to suffer. That you will get entangled into the karma or action. So karma or action can take us to peace, to freedom, or it can take us to bondage, to restlessness. The same activity, the same action can take us to freedom, can take us to bondage. Only when we change the attitude behind it, we know that we are going towards freedom. So Lord has said that there is no such thing called bad activities that will bring us to entanglement or bondage. Change the attitude, bring a proper attitude to it, and you will succeed. I'll take the name of this chapter is Karma Yoga. According to Kriya tradition, the masters have given that we have two channels. One is Ida on the left side, Pingala on the right side. Ida and Pingala are the channel of activities. When through meditation, the channels merge and the prana or the life force moves in Sushumna, then tranquility, peacefulness, placidity of the mind comes. This union of the two pranic channels is called yoga of action. And when this happens, mind becomes inward. So with this, we'll end chapter 3. Hopefully, tomorrow we'll again meet. We'll continue chapter 4, which becomes again more beautiful. With that, my prayers to Lord, my prayers to Masters, to guide each of us. Om Tat Sat Om. We'll meet in a minute, and then we'll do a little bit of bhajan. We'll take Lord's name. So give us a minute, or at 2, and then we'll be ready. Thank you.
Jai Guru.
जागा बंधु परी जाने सामंत नहीं नहीं ता जागा बंधु परी जाने सामंत नहीं नहीं ता चौदा भुवन बार जानती चौदा भुवन बार जानती चक्र रे छेदंती आरत नहीं नहीं तो जग बंधु परी जने सामंत नहीं नहीं तो जेते बेले कृष्णा गोपपुरे थिले अक्रूर आणी न गला तो जेते बेले कृष्णा गोपपुरे थिले अक्रूर आणी न गला तो गाई दोहो दोहो के सफीती गला गाई दोहो के सफीती गला चत्रु दूज हेले अनंत नहीं नहीं तो जग बंधु परी जने सामंत नहीं चौद भुवन बारता जानती चौद भुवन बारता जान धंदी आरत नहीं तो जग बंधु परिजनी सामंत नहीं तो रावण भ्राता जे शरण पशिला लंकागढ़ ताकु देल तो रावण भ्राता जे शरण पशिला लंकागढ़ ताकु देल तो गुरु सभा तले द्रौपदी चिंतिला गुरु सभा तले द्रौपदी चिंतिला कोटि वस्त्र दियाइले तो जग बंधु परिजनी सामंत नहीं तो जग बंधु परिजनी सामंत नहीं चौद भुवन बारता जानती चौद भुवन बारता जानती चक्र रे छेदंती आरत नहीं तो सफातले द्रौपदी चिंतिला कोटि वस्त्र दियाइले तो गुरु सफातले द्रौपदी चिंतिला कोटि वस्त्र दियाइले तो भारत युद्ध रे भरती आपकी भारत युद्ध रे भरती आपकी मंत्र घोड़ाइयो किले तो जग बंधु परिजनी सामंत नहीं तो जग बंधु परिजनी सामंत नहीं तो चौद भुवन बारता जानती चौद भुवन बारता जानती चक्र रे छेदंती आरत नहीं तो जग बंधु परिजनी सामंत नहीं तो हेमंत सामंत त्रिभुवने नहीं नासने आरते आरत हेमंत सामंत त्रिभुवने नहीं नासने आरते आरत कहे दिन कृष्ण दास जे श्री कृष्ण कहे दिन कृष्ण दास जे श्री कृष्ण पद्म पदे चित जग बंधु परिजनी सामंत नहीं तो जग बंधु परिजनी सामंत नहीं जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय राधा रमण हरि गोविंद जय जय राधा रमण हरि गोविंद जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय राधा रमण हरि गोविंद जय जय राधा रमण हरि गोविंद जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय राधा रमण हरि गोविंद जय जय राधा रमण हरि गोविंद जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय गंगा की जय जय यमुना की जय जय गंगा की जय जय यमुना की जय भानुद लारी राधा प्यारी की जय जय भानुद लारी राधा प्यारी की जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय 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 गोपाल ललिता की जय जय विशाखा की जय जय ललिता की जय जय विशाखा की जय गिरी गोवर्धन धारी की जय जय गिरी गोवर्धन धारी की जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय ब्रह्मा की जय जय विष्णु की जय जय ब्रह्मा की जय जय विष्णु की जय जय उमापति महादेव की जय जय उमापति महादेव की जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय राधा रमण हरि गोविंद जय जय राधा रमण हरि गोविंद जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय राधा रमण हरि गोविंद जय जय राधा रमण हरि गोविंद जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय
So we will chant Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushti Vardhanam
ഉരുവാരുകാമിവ വന്ദനാൻ മൃത്യുർമുക്ഷീയമാമൃതാത് ഓം ത്രയംബകം യജാമഹേ സുഗന്ധിം പുഷ്ടിവർദ്ധനം ഉരുവാരുകാമിവ വന്ദനാൻ മൃത്യുർമുക്ഷീയമാമൃതാത് ഓം ത്രയംബകം യജാമഹേ സുഗന്ധിം പുഷ്ടിവർദ്ധനം ഉരുവാരുകാമിവ വന്ദനാത് മൃത്യുർമുക്ഷീയമാമൃതാത് ഓം സർവേഷാം സ്വസ്തിർഭവതു സർവേഷാം ശാന്തിർഭവതു സർവേഷാം പൂർണം ഭവതു സർവേഷാം മംഗളം ഭവതു സർവേ ഭവന്തു സുഖിനഃ സർവേ സന്തു നിരാമയഃ സർവേ ഭദ്രാണി പശ്യന്തു മാ കശ്ചിദ് ദുഃഖഭാഗ് ഭവേത് അസതോ മാ സദ്ഗമയ തമസോ മാ ജ്യോതിർഗമയ മൃത്യോർമാ അമൃതം ഗമയ ഓം പൂർണമദഃ പൂർണമിദം പൂർണാത് പൂർണമുദച്യതേ പൂർണസ്യ പൂർണമാദായ പൂർണമേവാവശിഷ്യതേ ഓം ശാന്തി ശാന്തി ശാന്തി.
Thank you for joining our heartfelt gratitude, and thank you Prakashji for singing this beautiful song. This is a very popular song in Odisha. It means, oh Lord, you have blessed so many, and please bless me and let me be there at your feet. That is more or less the meaning of this beautiful song. Thank you Jagannath ji. And thanking Sampurnanand Ma, Frederick Baba, Matt Baba for organizing the technical aspect of it. May the blessings of God and Masters guide us, protect us, and be with us in each and every moment. Om Tat Sat Om.